there we go. God, the I do gotta give him credit. The destructible environment is probably one of the best I've seen in a very, very long time. I was planning on writing a series of games that you that make sense if you play all the series. So, like, what? The, Danganronpa games? I don't know what I need to do with this material stuff. Like, I keep getting it, but I haven't used it for anything. Like this, Alan Wake. Boop! They don't kill Dylan right away. Like, I'm hoping either he gets away or something. Like, he if they're trying to make this like a connective IP, I'm hoping they don't kill him, right? Oops. There we go, wrong button. I forgot about the shield, by the way. Do we have— damn it. I'm gonna hope I had enough. So I need one more ability to get the final. And then I can throw like a boss. Alright, Panopticon is over here. Okay. I guess we're not going that way. Medical wing. Yeah, I saw that, Deadly Premonition 2 is a thing. We played a little bit of it. It is not my game. Could not get past the writing, the graphics, the game. I couldn't get past any of it. It was, yeah, I really couldn't. Energy cost reduced, awesome. Energy boost increased. Headshot damage. I'd rather go with a headshot damage than anything else. But no, I saw like a buddy of mine got super excited because I guess Deadly Premonition 2 was announced for Switch. And in my mind, I'm like, eh. That's definitely not for me. Moonlighter's real good though. I got a good, 15 hours out of that game? Okay, but if you have a between food and game, always food. Woo! Always food. That's new. I don't know what that is. It's like a moldy monster. Yeah, so I got— I skipped at Spyro for a salty Saturday. We will be checking that game out on Saturday after Messenger. See, I think I'll be fine. I think I'll like it. It's just, from what I'm hearing and what SA also mentioned and a few other, like, websites, it's a little on the buggy side. So that should be, that should add to the salt, chat. Not as buggy as the fourth game. True, true, true. Anyone getting like a Last of Us feeling right about now? Oh my god, that'd be so cool if this actually was tied into Last of Us, but I doubt Sony would ever do that. Did I watch that series? I watched the like first 30 seconds of the first episode. And that gave me more than enough a reason to be like, yeah, probably not gonna play that game. You know, the Zero episode? Yep. It was designed so well. Oh my god. Alright, let's look around before I go in the center. Okay, hang on. Some of these are getting real good. Let me take a look at this. Health boost. Ammo refund on chance. Wait, then what is... exclusive to charge. I don't have charge. Also, I have 65,000 of a point system that I have no idea what that is or why I have that. A Skyrim boost command. August 4th, 1964. We discovered the oldest house while investigating a suspected altered world event case. Was there a way to watch this? Damn it.
Once we became aware of it, it was there. For the rest of the population, it was hiding in plain sight, a slippery blind spot, seemingly discouraging observation. It's a place of power, an ongoing AWE of its own, seemingly adhering to its physical outer constraints, and yet
also massive.
The known boundaries of reality. It's unstable, shifting. Note. For more details on control points and the research and process to stabilize and secure the core sectors, refer to a separate presentation. After extensive research and investigation, the Bureau made the building its headquarters on November 13th, 1968. The Federal Bureau of Control was never out in the open. This was always an obfuscated, classified top secret operation. So imagine our surprise when the building's observation resistant aspects began in some unquantifiable way to affect the Bureau as a whole.
Wait, did the building just pop up when they needed it the most? Yeah, like that's like that room in Harry Potter. But like it gives you whatever you need and it will appear. Two counters, death counter, butt counter. Is that how bad Spyro's gonna be? Also, for the record, Tony, again, you were there when I played Skyrim. I got, what, 4 hours, 5 hours in, and then we stopped? I did not get very far.
P6 is what the Bureau calls Dylan. His cell's been breached.
Okay.
They has found him. Are you there with him? Can you protect him?
Either found him, or the Hiss is going back to him. Oh, okay. Try that again. Whatever you do in your room is by you and only you, buddy. Wrong room, upside down. I just don't like the game nor the dev. What? Spyro or... Miss Bears, morning. Hope you're having a good day. We are in the final stretches, I believe, of Control. In which case, we'll be getting into Sinking City. It is that is blood. Bloody bad. Did that rotate the other room? Oh, Skyrim. I can see that. I wasn't really too sure with the hype of Skyrim, to be honest. I'm not even too sure with the hype of Elder Scrolls, but that's just me. So what's this game about? Oh boy. All right, I'm gonna give you a cliff notes. You ready? Okay. 17 years ago, this girl right here, she was like, I guess a kid, and she lived in the town of Ornay with her little brother. And I guess they came across a basically a projector that had different slides, and each slide had a different like supernatural world that they go into, and they ended up going into a world where they were given a creature being that was a like nice and happy called Polaris, which in both of them, and then somehow in the slides they were working on, they ended up bringing an evil thing into our world, and the nice thing actually helped them out. Well, because of that, it got the attention of the Bureau of Control, which is basically like the FBI, CIA, NSA, X-Files, all rolled in one. Super top secret classified. They came in, took all the kids that didn't get taken, because I guess all the adults just vanished. And she was able to get out of their grasp, but her little brother was taken. Skip to current time. Creature inside our little girl here, now a woman, has been guiding her to the Bureau of Control to find her brother Dylan. Okay. Somehow, we came across the director who ended up shooting himself. And we got access to a gun that makes us the director of the entire bureau. It is like a super weapon, able to form to whatever you need in the process. Good example, it was once Thor's weapon. Yeah. It feels kind of like Stranger Things, yeah. A little bit. It's kind of 80s-ish, but set in modern time. Because everything's like very 70s tech, right? Very old school, very analog, that sort of thing. Like, internet is separated, like they can't do internet normally in the building because fear of like things getting out through the wires. But I guess something called the Hiss is attacking the bureau, and we're trying to stop it, but trying to get to our brother, who we now realized was taken to become the next director, but I guess his power corrupted him in some way, and now he's like evil and stuff. But we're about ready to go talk to him and see like how evil he really is. Or whether or not he's working with the Hiss or what. Yeah. Basically, this is, if you're old school like me, this is X-Files. If you're modern, if you're like a little younger, this is SCP the game. It's like X-Files the game or SCP the game. What's weird is they use these switches right here because I guess it's connected to the oldest house, which is smack dab in the middle of New York City. I didn't realize how big the building was, but I guess it's 600 stories tall compared to like the tallest building in New York. It's
been a long time
weird.
Since Dylan and I knew each other. I wondered.
It's like Taken. Yeah, it's like Taken.
What kind of man he'd grow up to be. Things as hard for him as they were for me. Maybe in here, they were even harder.
Like, to give you an idea, we came across a disc, a floppy disc, that liked to use number two pencils to attack people with, because it could levitate them, fly them around, spin them really fast, and then throw them at you. We came across a rubber ducky at the moment, I'm not too sure what it does, but yeah. There's a refrigerator, it's a mini fridge, that if nobody's watching, it will, it'll teleport into people. And then open up. So it's a, like, serial killer mini fridge that wants to kill people by, like, teleporting inside of them. And so I guess there's people that have to, like, their job is to watch the fridge from doing, like, Scary shit. Off stream yesterday, I came across a file about a man who saw, like, shadow versions of people he loved trying to kill him, which I'm assuming is the Alan Wake reference. Hey, a few people. Hi. Man with a bad comb over.
Oh, hello. Is there something I can help you with?
I'm Jesse, the new director. I need to get inside.
New director? Right. Well, okay. Hello, I'm Frederick Langston, the Panopticon supervisor. It's not the best time for a tour. We have hiss everywhere, numerous cell breaches, and system failures across the board, but you're the director, so here we go. Founded by Zachariah Trench, the Panopticon is our state-of-the-art repository for all altered items.
I don't have time for this.
Power and...
I was told Dylan Faden was kept here. Can you help me find him?
Faden? Sure. Darling wanted him somewhere secure and isolated, away from people. He's in the maximum security cells, upper level. But there's currently a pressing matter, ma'am. We've got an object of power loose in there. It's wrecking the place. The Bankoff TV? It's a real doozy.
Oh, I love that.
Salvador took a team in to handle it, but no one's heard from them for hours. This is a Category 5 OOP we're talking about.
Oops.
If we don't contain it soon, it will tear the Panopticon apart. And we don't want all those altered items getting loose, ma'am. No, trust me.
That rubber ducky? It's an oops. That fridge is an oops.
Open the door, Langston. I'll handle it.
If you say so. I usually tell first-timers not to touch anything, so, just do that. Here, I'll get the door for you. And please, ma'am, call me Fred.
That's a floppy disk? It's an oops. So,
I told Salvador.
I love Remedy's, like, ideas of how they, like, name things.
I'm just a Panopticon supervisor.
Thermos procedure. Wait, hold on. Hang on. Oh dear, diner coffee thermos. No unique procedures required. Altered status is suspected, but unverified. Blue coffee thermos with a white plastic cap and a logo on the Oh Dear Diner, located in Bright Falls, Washington. The cap doubles as a mug. The item responds to Formula 1.16, yet no discernible altered effect has been discovered, other than keeping liquids warm for surprisingly long periods of time. It is also worth noting that the coffee from the thermos is always refreshing and strong, no matter its quality before being poured into the item. The thermos was discovered on the shore of Calden Lake outside the town of Bright Falls. Both are known sites of a reoccurring awe. Is it Bright Falls where Alan... There it is! According to witness statements, Alan Wake, C-Prime candidate program entry for further information, who went missing shortly before the discovery of the thermos, had been seen blank collecting similar thermoses for a blank purpose. That's another... Oh, I love it! Ah, so cool! Okay.
The Panopticon.
Though, to be fair, that would be awesome, right?
The power might wreck this place before I find him.
No matter what sort of... You could get the shittiest coffee, right? You could get Starbucks coffee. Dunkin' Donuts coffee. You pour that in. Shake it up. Instantly best coffee you're ever gonna have. And perfely hot. Not too hot, not too cold, but just perfect for your tastes. That would be an oops that I'd like. That would be a good oops. What is he, a dabbing monster? I mean... I'm pretty sure Trump dabbed at least a few weeks ago, so, you know, there is that. Why is there a mailbox? Fruit basket. A fan? Ooh, hammer. Why is one of the options?
Something went wrong with the Bureau's plan to make Dylan the next director. Marshall made it sound like it was all Dylan's fault, but how much of it was what the Bureau did to him?
Well, basically, it's any coffee you'd like. That would be your favorite, right? I mean, it's a lot better than having a disket that's trying to impale you with a freaking number two pencil. Or a toaster that, for whatever reason, will slightly shift something in the room and then mimic another object to confuse you. The weird thing is, they're not too sure what's up with that toaster, but apparently the toaster is trying to go somewhere. That's why it always shifts to the same, like, general direction. Such a weird little object. Why so serious?
Hello?
Pretty serious.
Is anyone there?
Wait. Yep, that's the fridge. Sterilize crystals with incantation before reusing. It's gotta be the fridge, right?
What are you doing in there?
Oh, thank God. Look, someone has to watch this object at all times, or it deviates. My shift replacement never showed up. Can you help me?
Damn. I can't. I'm sorry. There's an emergency. I'll come back. I promise.
Okay. Just don't forget. I can't stare at this thing much longer.
Okay, I want to help this guy out. Is this the agent in the Panopticon cell after Dylan has been found? Oh, okay, let's go find Dylan. I want to help this guy out because that fridge is going to go inside him otherwise. Piping hot coffee in a travel mug, sitting on the table, ready to go. So basically, it's a thermos, right? Hey, brada! Hey, he's a good guy. We don't even know if they have medical in this area. Hey, guys. Like a freaking boss that we all know that she is.
That's the object of power. I need to cleanse it.
I should also mention one thing. So, Miss Pierce, there are stages to the hiss. The first stage being you hover in the air and you chant. In unison, no less. Second stage is the guys that you saw teleport that started shooting. The third stage are the guys that teleported and fly. Fourth stage? Chick, it's weird. Water dance. You are getting slippy. That's not that bad.
Welcome to our world.
Man, if they all just dropped that, we did. Six stages, everything a lie. We're thinking Gravity Falls. Yeah. Man, thinking of Gravity Falls, I finished up Costume Quest. Season 2 has been confirmed. If you are a fan of Gravity Falls, thank you, Athday. Welcome back. You should check out Costume Quest. They took the game Costume Quest from Double Fine and made a cartoon. They got the animators behind.
Okay.
Adventure Time. Yes. Love you too, guys. Oh!
Hey!
May contain random shakes of the camera. I mean, I guess it's not as bad as we were in the other area yesterday. SA did a freaking horror command. I went right off the ledge. It was bad. I found the regional manager. He's kind of a monster. So good there too. I knew this was coming. I was ready. Oh, thank you for telling me about the shield that I completely forgot I had.
That's fine. We're all fine. Remember, we're fine.
Be fine. The coup? Be fine. The coup? Be fine. Where am I going? Where am I at? Do we gotta I gotta clear all the way over. Okay. Man, that is awesome and twisted at the same time. I know what I said yesterday. I know that we started the stream saying it'd be 25, and I said yesterday it'd be 15, and I'm very much aware of it. Very much aware of it. Trying to nuke the guy down quickly. Yeah, so two more. 15, not 13. 15.
At least I got everything working so far.
Oh, biscuits. ammo refund, energy, launch cost, health recovery. Let's up that health recovery, yeah? That way when I go over that, we'll be fine. Dude, don't spawn in those flying ones. I said don't you! Master! There we go. Get out of here. Weapon mods are full. Wait, is there another one around here? What do you mean weapon mods are full? Weapon mods are not full. I got 12 out of 24. What the hell are you Oh, those are full. Yeah, that's a stage 4. Yep. There we go. They're able to somehow, like, navigate around. The guy that we're fighting that I'm dying to, that's a stage 5? Basically, they are... They're essentially like the... They're the managers or supervisors of the area that have been completely turned. And given a great amount of power, too. Is that even... That even hitting you, bro? It's like they're getting better. Okay. Tea time comes on. Wondervade is in play. Now, I will stop sucking at this and somehow magically, through sheer will, get past this. Love that ragdoll. God damn, love that ragdoll. I really want to see this Dylan character. Because apparently, him becoming like a supernatural person, he lost hair? And it also. Actually, no, wait a minute. Anyone that goes with a hiss is losing body hair. Maybe he was controlled by the hiss early on instead. Tempted by its offers, and then that's why he lost hair? Can we say 2-for-1? Discount. Head of security or head of their department. They could turn into that.
Another object of power gone nuts. Here we go again.
Hang on before we go again. Get all the goodies before we go again. Because I keep getting all this remote stuff and I don't know what it is. See, chat, TV will rot your brain. Look at that. Warping reality. Use the TV, babysitter. Levitate superhero over the obstacle. Okay, hold on. New ability? Oh! But Jesus! We're up to Jesus, chat. Look at this. Oh! Okay, if they have a sequel, and so help me, they like strip her powers, I'm gonna be so upset. Oh! This is gonna be weird, right? I can fly and attack, and it doesn't take energy? Oh, that's nice. Newsflash, APB. You're in trouble. His static. Our broadcast must survive.
Okay. Dealt with the TV. Now I can find Dylan.
Oh. Oh. We're a freaking superhero, chat. Return to the Panopticon. Search for Dylan and max security on the 5th level. Wait. Boop. Oh my god, we can really fly. Oh. I did not know there'd be like fly mechanics in this game. That is a gigantic bird. Is that one of those, like, swan rides where, like, you say it? Yeah, it is. Oh, God, that is. Let me guess. Anyone that goes in this automatically falls in love. I only have eyes for you. Okay, morning. Hope you have a good day. Yeah, no, this is a damn good game.
Dylan.
Oh.
So close.
Knock knock. Excuse me? Baby brother! Have you been naughty? Oh, you've been naughty, haven't you?
Hello. Can you hear me? Are you there, Jesse?
Emily? He's gone. Dylan isn't here. He might be nearby.
Oh, shit.
Or maybe the hiss got to him. I don't know.
Jesse, listen. Dylan's here. With us. He just walked in. He says he is giving himself up. He's been affected by the hiss, but he is different than the others. We must isolate him.
I'm on my way.
God, he looks like Lex Luthor.
We need to get back.
Face the enemy.
I have to see my brother.
Whee! Oh, look at this. There's actually loot over here. That's awesome. Again, I keep getting these collectible items. I don't know what they're used for. I wish I knew, though. Fly so far away.
All right, I won't take up too much of your time today, Dylan. Like I said, I want to talk about Jessie, your sister.
What about her?
I just want to get your perspective. What do you think of her? What kind of person is she? That sort of thing.
I adored my sister. When I was little, I mean, back in ordinary.
And you don't anymore?
When I first got here, sure. I'd always hoped she'd come too. Find me, to take me home. We went everywhere together. Why should this be any different? Casper said she could come too, to the Bureau. If she wanted to. But she never did.
Why do you think that is?
Because she didn't care about me.
Oh, there it is.
She always wanted to be out on her own, seeing the world. She always said so. I guess she got what she wanted.
Great. So, she wanted to see the world. Did she ever mention any place in particular?
Why?
We like to ask questions around here, you know that. Any particular cities, towns, landmarks, anything like that?
I don't remember.
They're hunting for her.
Friends, were you close with anyone living outside of ordinary?
I'm done with this. Tell Casper I want pizza for lunch today.
Dylan, wait, we're not... End of session.
So, even though she was able to get out, they were still hunting her. Wow. Breakfast is brought, gets out of bed, uses toilet, returns to bed, asks for television to be turned on, staff do so. Lunch is brought, breakfast is removed, eats lunch, uses toilet, begins talking to self, recording speech is not possible due to noise from television. Becomes upset, throws the lunch tray at glass, sedated, crew clean the cell, television's turned off, asks for television to be turned on, staff refuse, sleeps. Television privileges were refused due to hostile behavior. He heard the hiss through the TV. It's gotta be it, right? Again, TV chat. It's so